Is there a fire in here? No more of that stuff. We don't need that to rock.
Thank you. What would you put down to the longevity of Green on Red? Why you're still around now?
Denial of our failure. You know.
They got an expression, they say the denial is not just a river that runs through Egypt.
Yeah, we're just stubborn, you know. And there's always another sucker around that'll give us money to make another record. And, you know, there's always somebody somewhere that wants to see us play. And
well, the thing is, I think really, because what we're doing is not necessarily pop music, which is something that's pretty popular here naturally, and it's
pop music
generally made by guys who went to art school and have some sort of clever aesthetic marketing sense of how to take advantage of
good haircut,
you know,
paisley shirt
of a moment, you know, in time and have a career that lasts like about a year or two. But we don't make pop music, you know. I mean, we cut our best records in Memphis, Tennessee. And people talk about that being the home place of rock and roll and all that, and that's true, but in Memphis, they don't make pop records. They never did.
Yeah.
Stax, those weren't pop records, man. That was soul music.
Yeah.
And all the Sun records, that wasn't pop music, man. That was like, it was like demented rockabilly or country or what have you.
See, we're willing
So we don't make pop music. So what we do, it's never really in fashion, but it never really goes away. And as long as we can figure out how to keep taking the same three chords, the four chords if you count the seventh chord, and keep regurgitating and recycling them and turning them a little bit sideways, then, you know, we keep making records.
That's old Double Clutch Larkin's on drums back there. You might want to give him your support tonight. He's a little nervous.
closing in my headlights, and I'm ready to roll. I've got you frozen in my headlights, and I'm ready to roll. Yeah, I'm heading down the highway, I'm gonna take your soul. I come from south of Juarez, job ain't never done. Yeah, I come from south of Juarez, sinner living under the gun.
Called Too Much Fun. If you're interested, you might want to pick it up and give it a listen. We like it. And I can't say that about all the records I've made.
Thank you.
soon you better go off in.
Get a job at the local Piggly Wiggly, selling beer to creeps all day. Well, nothing's changed in Memphis anyway. Dickens, I'm a zombie. I'm a zombie for love.
Anybody in this country outside of your elder generation of guitar statesmen, none of the young players know how to bend a note. They just refuse to bend a note, and I say, go ahead, let it out, bend a note, but they won't. Everything's based on that first Public Image single. The song itself, I believe, was called Public Image.
See, the Yardbirds.
And the Edge, the Edge, he's got his thing, and I like their last record because they came to Berlin, Now all they have to do is take a left turn and get back to fucking Ireland, but thank God they're out of Memphis, I mean, they did that record, Joshua Tree. We're really thinking about doing a record and calling it Stonehenge.
I mean, you think we could get away with that? I doubt it. Put it this way, the Yardbirds, they had a clue. They were really good. But they never really got any better after they went to Memphis. And what happened is they went to Memphis to record while they were on tour, and they cut, trying to keep a roll and stuff. And Sam Phillips was there. And Sam Phillips was finally just turned to the bass player. The guy was just playing this little feathery, light little thing, and he said, "Boy, I want you to stroke that thing like a mule's Peter."
Like a mule's dick.
I've been doing a lot of work on myself, I've been looking for trying to go on this journey to discover my inner child. And you know what? I found out it's that little kid from The Omen. Baby's not so fast. She likes to take it slow. And if you think you're crashing, feeling lost, baby's not so fast. Baby don't like sleep. She says her dreams are sad, and all she sees is her dad, and he's always. Baby loves her.
don't want to know your name. Because fellas, to her, you're all the same. Take away her.
Looking for horny toads.
drinking, shooting dope too. But one day I'll wake up in paradise with you. I got the hair of the dog. Sweet but Jesus, hair of the dog.
But basically songwriting, there's five songs in the history of Western folk music ever written. It's only about five, maybe six. And you just pick one, and what you do is you stamp your own kind of psychosis on it. You know, and some bands, and some great bands like R.E.M. and U2, they've only got one song. You know, but they keep doing it in a way, to producing it a little more, and it, you know, and people get more and more accepting of it, you know. I like to think that we generally have taken all six and juggle them in different ways, you know. It's like there's a reason why they sell beer in a six-pack. You know, they don't sell in a two-pack or a three-pack. No, six beers, because you need six beers when you sit down and drink a beer.
You know? If you take all this garbage, all this American traditional music, which comes from all over the place, and you take this folk stuff and this bluegrass stuff and country music and the blues and
the rhythms of deep, dark Africa,
kinds of R&B, and you stick it in a pot and you just sort of stir it up a little bit, and if you could bring it up to a boil, you know, really get it happening, and if you can manage to get it in the studio, you know, before it starts simmering, get it onto the tape, you've done your job. You know, it's like, after that, it's just, hey, put it out.
Like, we saw Nick Cave here the other night, and I'm a big fan of Nick. I think Nick understands a lot of this stuff. And we figured that each song Nick does, what he does is it's like it's on a gas stove, and he starts with it just on the simmer. And then he turns up the flame and it starts boiling. And then he turns it back down, you know. So it's always like, you know, you're getting ready to throw in the pasta. You know, he's like Tony Bennett, but with a backbeat.
And when he brings it down to where it's just, the song is just like crawling, you know. Just crawling like a little insect. He just turns up that first, whoa, like a bear, just gets back on his hind legs.
And we all know the gas.
Just swat you like a bee.
You know, everybody knows that it's easier to cook with gas than electric.
Can you speak English? I'm sorry, can you speak American? Oh, I heard that. Fuck off. Very inventive. So this is the middle part of the set that always drags, and we just figured we'd just go with it and just let it drag. This is a song called Little Things in Life. Give you a break. What do you want, honey? What can I do to help you? You having a bad night? Before I met you, baby, little things in life just passed me by. Oh my. Sound of children's laughter, tuned to some forgotten lullaby. Could call home. I was arrested by your beauty, locked into a cell of our own, of our own. No, I love you, baby. Collected crazy visions in my head. Yeah, I did. Got a scene from the night porter, broken jelly jar crushed by the bed. Filled me with dread. Oh no. No, I love you, baby. For you.
life just pass me by. Oh my, oh my. Color of the twilight, reflection of my smile in your sweet eyes. Sure looks nice, so fine. There's anything, just anything that I can do for you, honey. It's all for you.
Shot my baby, but they
I worked with a very famous English producer who I won't, you know, say his name, Glenn Johnson.
He had a technique.
And he had a technique, but his technique was like a schoolmaster. He made me work. He made me do take after take after take after take, you know. And I basically...
But what he was looking for, though, at the end of the day, and I finally figured this out, was that he would have us do the take so many times. And like the rundown would be great, because he'd hear the rundown, it'd be the first time you ever actually really heard the song. You know, because you can't hear what's going on in the room. You can't hear what's going on. They're here in the control room. You listen to the rundown, it's great. He goes, no, nuh-uh. Play it again, again. It just starts getting worse and worse and worse, and it gets totally tired. And then it passes a point.
Of exhaustion. Of like exhaustion. A marathon runner hitting the
and
wall.
And you play it again, and on the 35th take, man, it actually sounds better than the first take because it's so tired, it's laid back.
There's a song called Rock and Roll Disease.
One more for you, and then we'll have to go and leave you in the most loving arms of the Blue Airplanes. Mr. Morning Blue, is that you? The sun is breaking through, and I got no place to hide. It's always you about this time. Oh.
gonna be alright. Mr. Morning Blue, is that you by my door? This here is nothing new. We've been that way before. We're torn between the day and the night, and it's all over, but we're gonna be alright. Gonna be more to say. I haven't got a single clue, honey, and I'm gonna soon fade away.
Be good, be careful.